artifacts at home. All law enforcement in Syracuse for the first 70 years came from the Sheriff's Department in Davis County. George Frampton took care of a stray pen for cattle that got onto other people's property. Owners were fined to get their stock returned. Gerald Wade was the first community constable in the late 1920s and early 30s, whose duties were mostly settling irrigation disputes and taking care of stray animals. On March 1, 1950, Elvin Hansen was sworn in as the first Syracuse town marshal. His pay was $5 per month plus expenses. He had no equipment, and it is believed a set of handcuffs and a revolver were on loan from the Davis County Sheriff's Department. There were no facilities, not even a ticket book, to give out speeding tickets to violators of the law. Not that Syracuse had a crime wave, but the time after World War II proved to be more restless. For the first time, crimes became more than shot-out streetlights or Christmas lights or cars speeding down the street. Families started locking their doors, and occasionally places of business and homes were broken into. It was nice to know that there was a town marshal looking out for people's welfare and property. Delmar Stoker was the next appointed marshal in 1962 and remained until 1971. He requested a two-way radio and a speed radar, but received neither. Henry Martin was the next marshal, and the title changed to Chief of Police. He received the first police car, two-way radio, radar, and a small office by the town hall. By 1977, two other policemen were added to the force, and another car was provided. After this point, the police department continued to grow to the force that it is today. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. I hope you have a great day, and we'll see you tomorrow.